The file allocation table format was originally used in the late 1970s on floppy disks and became the standard in DOS and early Windows machines. It is still commonly used on solid-state and flash memory devices like this one. As these storage technologies have evolved, it has gone through many iterations, but the two key ideas have remained the same. The first is that each file is represented as a linked list of blocks. Normally, when we think of a linked list, we think of the links as being part of the nodes in the list. Maybe the last part of the block would give the ID of the next block. Here, however, the links in this list are represented in the file allocation table, which is indexed by block number. Giving the starting block number of a file, I can find the next block with a constant time access to the file allocation table. A special value, -1 in this example, indicates that a block is the last in the chain. This file allocation table also contains a bit to say whether a block is free or not. In this example, our file starts with block 2. Looking at the table, I see that the next block is 6. Looking at 6 in the table, I see that the next block is 3. Again, going back to the table, I see that the next block is 5. And when I look at 5 in the table, I see that its next has the special value indicating that we've reached the end of the file. It's important to realize that the file allocation table, or FAT for short, stores all the links for all the files. For instance, there appears to be another file occupying block 4, and only block 4, since that's the end, and also one occupying block 1. So the file allocation table tells us how to glue the blocks of a file together, but it doesn't tell us where to start these chains of blocks. That is the function of the directory tables. Directories, I should say, are indeed treated as files, and they use something called a directory table format. Entries in the table all have the same width and contain the essential information, including the file name, the starting block, and any other metadata associated with the file, such as permissions. The root file directory has a fixed address on the disk, so we always know how to get started. Let's say that I wanted the content of a file /foo/file.txt. I would first consult this root directory table. It would tell me that there is indeed a directory named foo and give me the starting block of that file. I would then access that file on the disk, and since it's a directory, I would look through there for the file name.txt, and it would tell me that the starting block is 2. I can then chain together the blocks on disk, as we did earlier, using the file allocation table. To summarize then, the FAT, or file allocation table, serves as the glue that chains the blocks of a file together. The directory files capture the hierarchy and the starting blocks for the files and all the metadata.